What's up, everybody? I'm Shade. Welcome back to Become a Legend, episode 38. And to start off the episode, we have the semi-finals in the World Cup against Italy. And the player ID thing that the developers talked about definitely got felt in this match, because Italy were just like they are in real life, such a physical, strong team. Of course, Cole getting a good challenge on him there, taking it like a boss. But from that free kick, we actually end up getting one goal from John Terry nonetheless. And did you see that goal? John Terry got a sideways scissor kick, if that's the name for it. Amazing stuff by the captain there. Of course, John Terry being congratulated by Cole and the rest of the England team. But as I've said, Italy were so strong in defense. Their marking was absolutely immaculate. We had to resort to short passing just because they would not give us the space for long passing. Cole gets fouled right at the edge of the box, and I don't know who that was, probably Ashley Young takes it, but Buffon is an awesome keeper, and it was so hard to just beat him. There's a goal after Cole's shot, but the assistant referee holds his flag up for offside, and the goal is of course cancelled. But we had to keep going. We could not resort on that 1-0 lead in the semi-final nonetheless. Cole with the shot at this right opportunity, but he just puts it wide of Buffon. Of course, Cole is disappointed just because it was a good opportunity. They have a corner though. Cole with the first touch. It's an awful touch. Gets tackled. They get the ball back and Balotelli puts it away. That was so disappointing, simply because I do not think that was my fault controlling the player. I think that was just... I think faulty engine on Pez's part, on the game's part. You'll see it at the replay. So I try to make the touch and just stop the ball, but Cole just kind of takes it in his own box and gets tackled. Then Mario Balotelli is there to finish. Cole with the shot just hits the post. Of course, he had Buffon beaten there, but he could not take advantage of the fact. But 90th minute, it's still 1-1. Cole, I don't think that cross even got to Cole's head, but it went straight into Buffon. But that's how it ended, the regular time anyway, so we have to go to extra time and penalties if necessary. I was so surprised that Cole didn't get substituted. He only has 67 stamina, and he already felt so fatigued. I'm so surprised they kept him in, but he gets fouled yet again. And that is the same situation as before. Ashley Young steps up for it. Ashley Young on the near post, pretty much. Buffon could not do anything about that. We get one goal over Italy. So we lead 2-1 now in the semifinals. What an important goal. Of course, Cole had his part to play in that as well. Just getting fouled. Hey, that's important too, you know. Somebody's got to do that. Cole, of course, with his dribbling and his pace, had to get fouled a lot. And that resulted in one goal. Cole... Look at that, he's on the pitch, he's on the laid out on the pitch, but he gets up. What a heart on that kid. He gets up, he's at the other side now when he takes the shot. Amazing work rates from Cole in this match. Kind of trying to make up for his mistake, even though it wasn't really his mistake at Italy's goal. But of course, if we lost simply because of that, Cole would have been disappointed. So Cole, one-on-one with the goalkeeper pretty much, but I don't know how he put that wide. So disappointing again. But fortunately for us, and fortunately for Cole, that is how it ends. So we are qualified to the World Cup final, which is an immense thing. Of course, Cole almost messed it up, but of course the team had to prevail in the end with Cole's help. Of course, we had a match in our own Brazilian league. But before we go into that match, I went to the training screen just to allocate the focus points from shooting on his dribbling, because I think his dribbling needed some more work. Anyway, this match in the Brazilian Cup or League is against Portuguesa. I'm not particularly familiar with them, but of course, Cole's mind was definitely on the final. That was only one match away now, and he saw this opportunity, this match as an opportunity to actually polish his skills and just train for the final. But stuff wasn't really going all that well in this match. Of course, he was getting fouled left and right as usual. That wasn't the annoyance to him. Over the head kick there, puts it wide as usual though. Cole gets a yellow card himself though, simply because he pretty much turned to be a bit of an aggressive player as of late, just because his work rates kind of increased. He's kind of a workhorse for the team now when he tries. Puts it wide again, and there it is. There's the frustration on Cole's part, because He cannot make the impact that he wants to. He cannot polish his skills for the final. He feels sloppy. He feels nervous, and that is not good, especially knowing the severity of the next match that he is going to participate in. But this match was just destined to be a nil-nil game, so that is what finishes, of course. But next match is indeed the World Cup final, and Cole, of course, we have faced Brazil once before in the group stages, I believe, and it was only a 2-2 draw with two beautiful goals by Cole, but we cannot beat them then. So there it is. There's the intro screen. What an epic occasion. What an awesome opportunity for a youngster like Cole. He's only 18 years of age, you remember that, and he's playing in the World Cup final for his England, for his national team. So that is not only an honor, but also kind of a huge pressure on such a young player, such young player's shoulders, to basically, nobody wants to be that guy that messes up in the final, let alone if you're playing for your country. You don't want to be that one that messed up the opportunity for your countries to basically be world champions. And that is something that Cole had to keep away from his game tonight, just because he had to put on a solid performance with the team as well. Of course, he's playing alongside Rooney. Rooney is, in a way, he's really good to play alongside because he's such a poacher. You know that he's going to be there to not only supply the pass and be strong enough to keep the ball for you, but if you are going to pass to him, he's such a poacher, you know he's going to finish it. Sometimes it's so annoying though, because he feels a bit selfish and he messes up. He seems to mess up really easy opportunities, but he seems to put away really hard opportunities. There's Cole though, singing his heart out on the national anthem, England national anthem, of course. Gerrard is the captain for this match, simply because Terry, I don't think Terry is even playing this match. Maybe he's a substitute, maybe he's fatigued, but the World Cup final finally begins. First shot of the game is, of course, taken by Cole. Sadly, though, it gets blocked. It was a finesse shot inside the box. It gets blocked, though. We get the ball back. A long shot from, I'm not sure who that is. Probably Gerrard. Probably not, though. Cole, though, with a pass, makes the run. Gets the ball back. Fake shot inside the box. Takes the shot with his right foot, and that is a goal in the World Cup final. Such composure on the little kid. And of course, the inconsistency and the nerve-wracking attitude that I was talking about didn't come into play there. Cole with the beautiful goal there, beautiful composure, as I said, to just look at this fake shot here, to just position himself and take the defender out of play to put it inside the net. It could prove to be an awesomely important goal for England, but then Nene is inside the box near post, and that is a goal. That should not be happening. This is not FIFA. The near post is not nearly as OP as it is in FIFA. But as you'll see in the replay in just a few moments, that was all Joe Hart's fault for me. He should just have that covered on his near post. Basically, look, it just kind of surprised him, I guess. But still, it should not be going in. So disappointing to cancel out Cole's important goal at the other end, though. Cole took another finesse shot there, but that is how the first half finishes. They only have one shot, the shot that was a goal. We are pretty much dominating as far as shots go, but the possession is pretty much even. So we just have to stay clear of their counterattacks and just kind of not defend our lead, but of course, go for a higher lead. And Cole gets a yellow card in the World Cup final as well, simply because, as I've said, he's so active all over the pitch now when he tries to get the ball back, and sometimes he's just too aggressive at it. A not particularly good shot there by Cole, but look at this finesse shot with his right foot, hits the inside of the post and then just goes wide. That's only a goal kick, so disappointingly close. But Cole with the pass for Rooney, and he puts it away. That's Cole's assist, and it's 2-1. Of course, we regained our advantage over Brazil. That is so good to see. Of course, basically Cole made that goal as well, and it's turning into an awesome Cole performance. Of course, he wasn't in form before the match, but it seems that Cole is, of course, performing very well in the top matches that he should be performing in, too. Pass to Rooney. Rooney gets it back for Cole, but the keeper saves it. The keeper was, of course, not the keeper from Sao Paulo, but a different one. But we get another goal from Rooney again. Good vision by the teammate that was wide there to just put it inside the box, right into Rooney's path for an easy tap-in. And that is 3-1 against Brazil in the final. And we should not be losing it from here. It's pretty late on as well. We got a two-goal advantage, 70th minute. Cole uses the last amount of energy he has left to just make a good run, but he's not composed enough anymore to finish that. Hopefully that won't come back to haunt him. Good ball for Rooney, but Rooney puts it wide himself. And another opportunity, though. Cole gets the ball, sees the run, makes the pass, but Rooney again puts it wide. 82nd minute, Cole with the sprint speed there, and he is looking to pass it inside the box, which he does, but Rooney again misses just wide there. And of course Rooney gets into a fight afterward in a little push and shove, but that wasn't enough. That is how it ended. We have won the World Cup, and it's amazing. At only 18 years of age, Cole, with his national team, is champion of the world. Of course, you'll see an epic scenery in just a little moment that just kind of stuck by me after I played this match. Look at this. Basically, Hulk and Ronaldinho. In the background is, of course, Cole with his team. Ronaldinho with a sad look on his face, and Cole just celebrating in the background, blowing kisses to the camera. England lift the trophy, the World Cup trophy. Such an awesome moment to just kind of call yourself champion of the world. Cole there with his fist pumping action going on. So in the end, it was 3-1. One goal by Cole, one assist by Cole, two goals by Rooney. But Cole will end up getting a higher rating than Rooney simply because he just was a lot more active than Rooney. Rooney was just kind of there at the right time. But Cole was kind of everywhere. He had to do all the work. And it was just an awesome performance by Cole. So proud of that outcome. And of course we won. After the match though, we first announcement, of course, apparently our focus points have increased. So we have one more focus point. I don't really know based on what that happens, but it's always nice to get more. We put it into shooting. We, of course, got some awards. We are player of the tournament in the team of the tournament alongside Ronaldo. And we also are the top goal scorer for the World Cup. So that is that. And we are just having an awesome time now. Of course, celebrations will be ending soon, but not too soon. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, do leave a like. I've been Shay. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.